Hello everyone, this is the LEGO Overwatch Tracer versus Widowmaker set. It's a simple one, a small one relative to the others, but it's actually pretty good in my opinion. It hides something that was unnecessary that was nice for them to include with the drone, the payload drone there in the middle, which is taken straight from the Watchpoint Gibraltar map. It's the payload that you have to escort, and this is of course intended to work very nicely with the Watchpoint Gibraltar set, where you can connect this up to the big rocket if you want to separately. This old set, I'm just going to take the base off really quickly, but you know, you can just place that right on the back of that. It's how it's intended to work, or you can just leave it on its own if you want. The thing that I took off from underneath this was just this. It's a printed large dish piece, which represents the drone charge station that is one of the checkpoints along the way on that map. It just has a little clear piece on the top, and you just attach it right here to make it look like it's hovering like it does in-game. The build of this drone is, well, I guess it's not the most advanced build. I kind of like the thrusters here on the back, but, you know, there's not all that much to it. It's kind of simple looking. It does have a openable container here in the back. You can put something in there like a health pack or something. You can change the angles of these ever so slightly. Not really though. Not really. Does rely on stickers a little bit for the decorations on the drone itself. This lower base piece is printed, but one of the nicer things that they have done with this in terms of the build is hidden beneath these two 2x3 tile pieces. It's completely unnecessary. If you want to put a figure on this, you don't have a figure pretending to operate the thing, or at least to take a ride on it. You can just sit them right there, right? Simple enough. Well, the LEGO designer actually decided to go one better than that. Have the removable panels there. A printed console at the front, which actually looks perfectly fine to me. Looks pretty good, actually. What it is, you know, it's an old existing piece, but now you can just place a figure in there to make it look even more like the figure is operating the thing, like it's a vehicle for that character. I don't think that in-universe it's supposed to do that at all, and I don't mind this inaccuracy, if you will, because this is LEGO just doing the ultimate LEGOification of something, not just trying to use LEGO pieces to make a reasonable representation of something, but embracing the fact that this is a physical medium. You know, it's not just taking something from a digital game and making it physical, trying to make it look as much like the original as possible. It's recognizing that this is something that you build with, this is something that you can play with, and so, you know, just going a little bit farther with it. It's a simple thing, but I like it. Yeah, that's pretty much all there is to see here. Simple on the underside. I think it's perfectly fine for what it is. Maybe just a little bit better than it needs to be, thanks to the inclusion of that one little extra feature. For a lot of people, probably the figures are the most interesting things in this set. And here's Tracer. She's got the blink trail that's attached to the back that looks very awkward like this, I think. Not a great LEGOification of a feature, but fortunately it is LEGO, so you can just leave that off if you hate how it looks. She's got her two pistols there, which are identical and use the new piece for 2019, which looks pretty good. Hair piece is also new, dark brown color there. The print for the face is good. It's nice and crisp, and you know, it's clear what they were trying to portray there. The print on the torso is not bad, at least the design is pretty good. You can see some air bubbles got into the paint there just a bit, just a tiny bit. But overall, this is a pretty good looking figure. Does get an alternate face, which is nice. And the print on the back of the torso is pretty great. I strongly recommend leaving this off unless you just love how it looks. I think this figure looks so much better with that off. It's one of the great things about LEGO, just being able to change things when they let you. When they don't use any, you know, super specialized pieces or combinations of things that can't be taken apart. And then here's Widowmaker. I think the print for the torso looks very good. Also for the hips, you know, it fits. The leg design, the print of the print design for the legs, I think looks good, but it definitely needed some more opacity so that you would get that brighter pink color where it's printed on there. It's just a little bit lacking. The headgear piece looks pretty good to me. I think the face here, I don't know, just this is definitely going to be very subjective, but I don't like that face just relative to the real in-game model. You know, just doesn't feel like it captures the essence of that character quite as much as I would like to see. I don't know, it just seems a little bit too much of a generic villain. The weapon is wonderful. It's a fully built-up thing. You know, it uses that same new pistol piece again for basically the receiver section of it, but then all the other parts are just pieces that are added on, and it always just feels good to me to build up a weapon, you know, or to build up anything that is nicely detailed that's small. And they make good use of some relatively recent pieces. The back of the torso looks great again, and she has that alternate face. Now this one looks better to me. I know that they needed to have both of these expressions. I just feel like this is a little bit closer to her. And I can't quite put my finger on it exactly what it is, but I like this one better. Also included is one of these health packs with the printed 1x1 cylinder there. Not the best print, but still a pretty cool looking thing. And at the end of the build, I was left with these spares. Not a huge selection. You wouldn't expect a whole lot of pieces from such a small set, but the pieces that are here are pretty nice for custom builders, especially, you know, some useful small pieces that we don't get a lot of. Based on the volume of stuff here, I would like to see this sold for about the price of a battle pack, you know, a figure battle pack, or maybe just a little bit more than that, and given the volume of stuff, and considering the fact that there's a very nice printed, you know, the checkpoint piece beneath there, and, what do you know, it's priced at $15. I think that is a reasonable price for this, and it's a pretty good build, and you definitely get some nice pieces in here. I think the drone itself is probably not a major draw. I don't know if a lot of people who would be interested in the set in general, especially for the figures, would want all of this, would want to pay for all of this. Just feel like maybe if this had just been set up as a battle pack with a couple other figures, maybe one other proper figure than one just extra might have been a better way to go about it. But I appreciate the fact that this will work with the Watchpoint Gibraltar set and everything, and for what it is, it's pretty well done. So, no major complaints here from me. That's it for my review, though. Check out the speed build if you'd like to. I will link to it presently, and I'll talk to you again soon.